Video like this and you wonder, how could something like this happen again? Meteorologist Melissa Nord is here now to explain how it can happen. Melissa?
And it really comes to topography and where Ellicott City was built. Its first purpose back in the 1700s was for a mill town, and it was a perfect location right on the Tiber River, several creeks and streams flowing into it. But now, with these heavy rain events that we've had in the last 2 years, it is a bad situation. For kind of a reference, Ellicott City sits right along the Patapsco River, but within Ellicott City, there's actually three little tributaries in its watershed that flow right into Main Street, the downtown area right underneath Main Street. That's the Hudson Branch, the Tiber Branch, and the New Cut Branch. All of those within just a few square miles converging. And believe it or not, it's actually about a 200-foot drop from the highest hills down into the valley, and Ellicott City is in the bottom of that valley, right along the Patapsco River. So they end up with these situations. We've got saturated ground. The water has to go somewhere, so it flows down those hills into the creeks, which are little trickles of water on a sunny day. But on days like yesterday, 10 inches of rain in some spots near Ellicott City, it comes rushing into those creeks and they become mad powerful forces of water. So there's a look at the radar image from yesterday, how much rain we actually received in that small little area. It was locally 7 to 10 inches of rain. Our forecast the next 12 hours, we're no longer dealing with heavy rain. We've had the cloudy skies around, which we're still going to have for the rest of the overnight with some areas of fog. But I'm tracking more showers and storms this week. Tropical moisture and subtropical storm Alberto just made landfall along the Florida Panhandle. I'm going to talk about coming up how that's going to influence our weather later this week, and we'll check out your forecast into next weekend.